Okay. It's like a maze trying to fucking get in here.
Hello. Welcome. Oh shit. I am
going to be using some techniques that we've learned throughout the God, it's been almost a year since we started painting. Hopefully we did something cool going. My hands are already covered in paint. Nice. Got a mix of the liquid white here. It's like settled. I don't really know if I can get this in the shot. There's like this, you know, the paint has settled to the bottom and there's an oil in it that thins the paint. And when you don't, you know, you let it sit, when you don't mix it, it separates. Not good. I have my microphone here today because typically I tend to talk into the painting. So hopefully that'll help. Okay. Get some paper towels ready. I've got shop rags so I can wipe off the excess paint. I'm so excited about that. I may need to get a new 2-inch brush soon. I don't know if it's very visible, but there's some frayed ends. And when I first got it, I didn't take care of it as best as I should. RIP. So I'm going to start by covering the entire canvas with white. Really kind of work it in there. Need a whole lot. I love this new easel, man. I can actually, my old easel only like it came down and covered both the bottom and the top. So I couldn't really get at those parts of the canvas. Really felt bad because, like, some of my paintings have, like, a little chip in the top where I just, like, couldn't reach the fucking canvas. It's just like solid white. Gonna do something quick while I'm thinking about it. Gotta move this down slightly because there is a little lip here that cuts off like literally a millimeter. So I want to get it up on top of this lip here. Then push it up. Fuck. This is hard to do with only two hands. I might push back during the painting, but that's okay. We'll deal with it. Gotta make sure nothing gets on my mask. You can't see, you can kind of see it down in the bottom left of the frame. I've got a mask down there. Don't want it to get screwed up. I didn't even pour my paint thinner. This is probably the most time-consuming part of the fucking painting. Just getting this to be right. It's already come off once. I think I got everywhere. So the real test to see if you have enough or if you have too much liquid white is doing a little bit of a fingerprint, and if you can still see your fingerprint through the white, then you're good. So we're good with that amount. I kind of want to take a little bit off. It might be just the light. But it looks like I have a lot on. It didn't seem like it. Maybe I'll do another pass with a clean brush. I gotta pour my Yo, I have a fucking
Bobby boy. It's Bobby boy. It's also gross.
Oh, I need to open the fucking window. I'm gonna suffocate in here if I don't. Ooh, there's a spider. I wish I didn't know that there was a bunch of spiders over there. That was information I didn't need to know. So we use an odorless paint thinner, according to Bob. I'm gonna have to be out of frame to clean my brushes because I don't have a bin. I don't have something to like set my paint in or my paint thinner in. Mind me. Just beating the devil out of it. Yeah, this brush is like kind of starting to fall apart. Okay, we got a little bit off. Okay. Now I need to get my palette ready. So today, I'm not doing a Bob Ross paint along video. This is the first time I'm going to be doing this. I mean, technically, that painting is a Kevin Hill painting. But this is a non-tutorial painting. I'm going to be using a limited color palette. Using this is permanent alizarin crimson words, ivory black. I have one that's open. Yeah. These. So I figured out the issue I was having with some of the mounds that I was making. So these are the two types of, I've actually got a third type of paint. The most, the cheapest Michael's paint is Artist Loft. It's just like $5 for just for a little tube. Then there's Winsor & Newton, which I like the most. And then I got this Blick, like store brand. I've never tried this stuff. But the reason why some of my mountains just like weren't coming out, or at least according to Bobby Boy, was because my paint wasn't firm enough. And he says, you know, if your paint is so runny, it's not gonna go on, it's not gonna apply very well. This Winsor paint, it's more expensive because it's just higher quality paint. And I like it better, and it doesn't run as much. But I don't have that many colors in that type of paint. Not very much white left in there. Just open a new one. So I've also got this. I've been wanting to use this purple, this violet, but if I'm going to use red, I'm certainly going to use phthalo blue. Think I have an open one. So we can just make purple, and that's okay. So four colors. I think that should be good. Trying to think. So I have a goal. And my goal is to have a lot of mountains, because I love mountains. Freaking love mountains. Freaking love them. There's so many. So many paints. Also failed to properly clean my palette. It's no longer clear. Try and shake these up as best I can. Is this one new? The Artist Loft paint, when it's new, is when it's the most runny. Because all the oil's still in there. It's like, you know, settled, just like the liquid white, all of the linseed oil has settled at the bottom and makes its way up. So I kind of have to zhush it out, otherwise it'll get all runny. That's why all my paint was looking like poop on the palette. No joke. When I'm holding my palette sideways and the paint's like literally moving, that's what you don't want. Your paint has to be firm enough to be able to move around with your palette in your hand, you know? So it's four. Covered in paint already. All right. Blue. This is a good blue. This one's getting down to the end, so I don't have to deal with all that oil. As I say that, hope everyone's having a good night. hopefully this Windsor black does a little bit better. The problem is it's like $7 for a tube like this that lasts me like, you know, maybe three paintings. Which is okay if I like sold more, you know? But I don't. Sold one painting. Oh man, that's about as much paint as I'm going to get out of that one. I hope the nature sounds aren't terribly loud. It's supposed to complement things. I'm gonna have to get more paper towels. Okay. So there's my four colors. Boom! Easy. Easy peasy. I'm probably gonna need some more red, but red's a pretty powerful color. So maybe not yet. Let me take a drink and think for a bit. Probably going to have solid purple sky. What's up, Sal? Day one of asking Avex to play League on stream. That might be like the only time I'd actually have time to play. I was looking at my account. I have some old shit, but I missed so much, dude. I have no idea what's going on. Like, there's like, it was like, not masteries or anything like that, but it was like this, if you're a support character, pick this, and then as you deal damage, you'll deal more damage, and if you get takedowns, you know, there's one for each different type of person. Like if you're an AP person, if you're a tank, if you're, you know, using attack speed, you gain attack speed. It's pretty, seems pretty cool. They've like introduced more than runes. I fucking hated the rune system. All right, where's my brush? So, I guess I can do the clouds in afterwards. We'll just go for a kind of melancholy dark sky. Really beat it into the bristles. What are you painting? Whatever comes to mind. No Bobby Boy today. It's tough to get up here. Like real tough. Expecting this to be a bit darker, but that's okay. Now we can blend it basically however fine we want it to be. We're already starting to see some. Oh man, the glare is fucking terrible. Is it from this? Hang on. What if I angle this one up? Sorry, guys.
Painting ghost face? Yeah, just white. I could paint a ghost face.
What if we take that there? That's a little dark on the right. Sorry, guys. Figuring this out on the fly. I want you to be able to actually see the fucking painting. I mean, that glare is still pretty killer.
I didn't realize I was so close. Don't fall. Don't fall. Oh man, my eyes. Can't see. Fucking blinded by the light, dude. Straight up. There's no way that's bouncing, that's fine.
Let me get on the other side.
I'm trying new setups every time I paint because I want it to look good, you know?
Maybe that's just the white balance. Try that. And I gotta crawl underneath my fucking camera. Looks a little better. I'm super dark though. That's okay. You don't need to see me. Alright, let's blend this out a little bit. I want it to be a little bit more smooth. Not so grainy. You always want to blend from the top down, getting rid of, you know, any kind of stroke marks. You go from the top down because as you go down, you pick up paint. And you don't want the bottom layers to be darker than the top layers, because that ruins the depth of field. You need some kind of depth. As things get closer, or as the sky gets closer, it gets lighter and lighter. Okay, let's I'm probably not gonna even use water, but never hurt anybody. Painting the wood. Still pretty bad glare there. The canvases that I've been using recently, they're all from the same like package, all the same brand. They all have this weird, I wish I could show it up close, but it's just a deformation, I guess, of the canvas. It doesn't have the same canvas texture as the rest of it, which is super weird. It's just a defect of being, you know, a cheap canvas, but here we go. That's the painting. I call it Anxiety. I'm just kidding. That was a joke. So Sal, you've been enjoying Kitty Person? I've not checked out any of the new champs. I don't know if you saw on Discord, but I've been out for 27 champions. 27. It's a lot. So I was trying to go for a little bit more of a melancholy look, but this is pretty, still pretty bright. Guess I should do some clouds. Yeah. Let's use a fan brush. ASMR time? No. No. Load it up full of paint. I'm just going to use whatever's already here, kind of, as like a baseline for some of the clouds. Because, you know, as we put paint onto the canvas took what it wanted and gave us back the rest. Some of this is just going to get covered up by mountains anyway. I want it to be a little bit brighter. Just give it a little bit of a fluffy attitude. Trying to keep these relatively small because I don't man, almost died. I don't want the main focus to be taken away from whatever I decide to do with mountains. So I'm gonna have mountains. That's about the only thing that I'm sure of in this painting. Doesn't really look like much right now because there's really no dark. In order to really see the light, there has to be some kind of dark, you know? You know? This is where clouds live, in my world. How about yours?
Thanks, Miss Confine. It's just blue. But thanks. I appreciate it.
Okay, I need wipe off my brush. So I need to make a low light to highlight the highlights. So I'm gonna be, oh, that's a lot. This might be a little too dark. That's okay. You'll make mistakes, okay? Okay. I want this to be a little bit more in the purple area. And we can come back and do another pass of highlights after we blend this all out. Hopefully it'll work. Who knows? We're gonna find out. Yeah, it's gonna be some happy trees, maybe, Laura. What's up? Hopefully it'll blend out to be not so comical. Looks kind of very just like, oh, there's a light side and a dark side, that's it. Okay, I'm not going to worry about these clouds here. I think I'll give them a little bit of love. Just because I'm feeling generous. Okay, I think I can't really use my 2-inch brush because the area is too small. I want to I guess I could do that to make them slightly bigger and then go back with the fan brush to add in some more highlight. Let's try that. Seems risky, but it's okay.
don't know, man.
This 2-inch brush is pretty freaking big.
Let's try it with this one. Okay, it kind of killed the light, but that's okay. A little bit of this blending and I'll lift them up and then add some highlight. I'm trying to make it a more easy gradient between the light and the dark. They look kind of like pieces of grass up close. Probably should have just used the 2-inch brush to begin with. Just because this is way faster. That's okay. I don't know if that is apparent, but it seems to have softened it a little bit. It's not so harsh. Of a, oh, here's white, here's dark. You know? Can you call it Tim? Tim the cabin. Sure. I don't know if that'll happen, but we'll see. I'm just kind of just going, you know? Let's fluff them up a little bit. Two hairs and some air. I'll come back in my round brush back into the white. Might have already hit the point where there's too much paint in this spot to really do too much else with these clouds.
Not all of them need like a drastic highlight either. This brush costs like fucking $12 and the bristles are already coming out. I've used it like twice. I'm gonna lift those a little bit, see if that helps any. I'm not pleased with the cloud, but I'm not dissatisfied. Fun time. Tim the cabin. Now I feel like I have to make a cabin and name it Tim. This would also be a new first. So since I'm left-handed. Hey, what's up, Luna? My light is coming from that way, so I'm actually going to be able to paint left-handed. All of Bobby Boy's videos are righty, because he's a right-handed person. Fucking weirdo. I'm just kidding. You paint with whatever hand is easiest for you. Okay, so I want two big mountain stuffs. I want one kind of over here, and one like right over there. So this one in the back needs to be a little bit lighter. So take some blue, a little bit of red, a touch of black. Bit of white. And this we can use the shop rags for to wipe away some of the excess paint to make it even lighter. Okay. Shoo. You don't have to. No, it's all good, Laura. It's all good. Not stuffs.
Stuffs.
Stuff and things.
I really don't like that there's so many of these, like, clouds that I decided to do nothing with right here, so we're gonna chomp them off. But let's come in. If I don't put any gigantic pine trees, Bob's gonna have a fit. So maybe we just
just broke a canvas. Do I have titanium white?
Yes, I do.
It's on the palette.
Right here.
So I want the other mountain to come in and dominate right here. So this stuff needs to be a little bit lighter. I'm going to take 2-inch brush and get this shit out of here. Now I gotta kind of shape the mountain how I want it.
Okay.
Give me one sec.
Oh no. My paper towel roll.
So these are less abrasive, these shop rags. Less abrasive than paper towels, so I can come in here. And get rid of some of this paint.
without getting that texture of paper towel on the canvas. So now there's very, very little paint on the canvas. I can come back with the 2-inch brush and reshape everything again. That one mountain has like
the black kitty.
Oh. Poor black kitty doesn't have a buddy anymore. It's not yet. Okay, paper towel. So this is still in the background, so it needs the highlights, but these highlights can't be overbearing. So just take a little bit of that color we just used for the mountain, and just a little bit of white. Little bit more. That looks good. Try to keep it marbled, because if you see, I can't really see. This here is like a marbled blue and white. It keeps things fresh and exciting, hip, when putting the paint on, so it gives it a little bit more randomness. It's not just white. Just finished watching The Seven Deadly Sins. Don't know what to do with yourself. Watch Stranger Things, I guess. It does not have nearly enough white in it to be distinguishable from the background. Oopsie. If you mix the paint too much, you get rid of that marbled effect. That's no good. It's like basically indecipherable. Sorry, I'm way over here. Trying to get something good.
I'm just gonna have to use more white.
Holy shit.
It's still too blue. What the fuck? Where's all the white going? I'm getting like really pissed off. I don't know what's happening. The blue is just so fucking powerful. A lot better. Bluest is the bestest after. Yeah, purple is like the only color that matters. There's a peak here, right here. It's like a double peak. I'm gonna use this short end of my palette knife to do just a basic mini version of what we've been doing. Just because that's a peak in the distance. This mountain here is gonna come whoop, hopefully right down. Sorry, I'm not talking much, guys. Just kind of focused. Happens a lot when I'm painting. I apologize. Hey, what's up, Sword? I'm not big on painting on the sides of the canvas. It has like really cool effects, but like my goal is to have my paintings in frames. So you're never gonna see it anyway. Abandoned me so many times. I help him and he leaves me to die. What character was he playing? Okay, so we can take that color that we tried earlier and add a little bit of red and black. A bit more black. Kind of like that color. This might not translate well, but we'll see. Oh, it's just like straight fucking gray. Can't even see the streaks of other colors. No thanks. Looks like mush.
just has to be a dark color, a dark, interesting color. We're both playing for. Are you just playing Rengar? Hopefully I'll have something down there to cover that up a little bit.
I'm alert. How are you, dude?
GG.
Do. I'm gonna add, well, the bottom of it's gonna be a little bit foggy, so we're gonna not really see too much of it. At least that's the goal, to not see too much.
Lurking, watching YouTube.
I don't know what's happening with these mountains, but whatever. Let me see how they look on the stream. I think they look better on stream. Need a fucking drink. Don't do. I think those clouds look fucking terrible. Oh man. I got paint on the inside of my palette. So it's just like in the crevice of my finger thumb. Oh, and the underside? Oh, man. That is not doing it. Okay. We need to thin this out a little bit. Get a little foggy. Silent Hill's rolling in. I'm gonna go pretty high up, because remember these are supposed to be in the background. Thank you. Two hairs and some air. I think now I need to decide if I want what I want in my foreground. So we know that there's going to be another mountain coming here. That's going to be sort of in the foreground. I think I want a little bit of water here. Maybe just like this chunk here. Maybe some land comes over here. I'm going to use... So these things have to be kind of small, because they're going to be far away. So, and it is far away, so it's got to be a little bit light too. See how this looks. Okay. The mountain's gonna come over here, and we want a little bit of land here. Maybe the land's just up front here, and there's still some water back here. Maybe it like snakes through. If that's the case, we can do this no matter what, but we're gonna need to. There's a lot of white left on my canvas. It's kind of annoying. It's these spots that like the canvas is all fucked. So like it's just because of the company that makes them. Just like doesn't pick up paint because it's made just differently and poorly. I've not really used the red, but we gotta make another mountain. God. So let's make the dark side of the mountain. Real fucking purple. Big decisions. Hmm.
Zoom.
Still pretty blue.
I don't know what to do with the mountain.
Oh, fuck.
Could just come so sort of fucking zoop right down. Pull the paint out. Try to get as much off the canvas as we can. I need to figure out the fucking peaks of this thing. Okay, I think I want it to come a little bit farther over. Now seeing that it doesn't really connect with this thing. It's got to cover this area here. Get as much paint off as I can. That mountain looks fucking weird. Need to play a league one day? Yeah, man. Also get a haircut. How about fuck off? You love playing easy mode? So the light's coming from this way. So we need to highlight that. That's dark. I think this will be light. Some hidden peaks, maybe. Okay, I think I have some ideas.
You look homeless?
Okay. Clearly, I am in a home. Doesn't mean it's mine.
I'm a fucking smurf.
Not a homeless man.
What are you talking about? What you talking about? Okay, I'm gonna use for the highlight. Some white, some red, and blue.
Not white enough. There's not really much red in there.
weird not having any browns or anything to use. I guess I want that whole side this color. I want another peak in here to kind of break it up. The white goes this way. Guess that could be okay. Then this stuff needs to be dark. This is dark. It's a very red, white, and blue palette. Hope everyone's having a good night. This is going to be dark coming down here. I think I want another light peak here. this an almighty mountain or what? I don't know why that's so dark, but whatever. Okay, I need a color for the shadows. This spot seems like... Why is it so wide open? I stepped on a slug? Oh, poor slug. Poor slug. Let me see what color this looks like first. It's okay. Looks a little too dark. Poor me? Nah. Poor the creature you probably killed. Best thing about palette knife is its purpose. Scraping off paint you don't like.
Still seems pretty dark, but it's supposed to be, because, you know, gotta differentiate it from the other mountain. Gotta be a little bit darker. Mix more of this color. Use so much paint. Getting there. Take it forever. It's done in with what is apparently called the instep arch of your foot.
Okay, like the inside of your foot. Like the inside of the arch. More light color.
don't know what the fuck's going on with that front one, but whatever, we can cover it up. Take a very, very little bit of the dark color and just kind of plop it in some places. Do the same with the red. Just give a little bit of color. Okay. I do want to do another pass through with just straight white.
God damn.
No more room on my palette. Glad I don't have other colors. Just to give the tops a little bit more pizzazz. They stand out. Looks okay. Let me clean my palette knife. Grab a drink. I might give that one little weird bit here some highlight just to make it look different. Looks a little better. It's like not quite a highlight, but not quite a low light. All right, I gotta fog it out. I'll say thanks for everyone for sticking with me. My first time doing a painting that doesn't involve
someone kind of going through the ropes. Okay. A little foggy. So, I kind of want to lay in some trees here just to push it back even farther. I just use my 1-inch brush. Might take forever. Ugh. Let's try it. For this, we can use a similar color to the mountains, a little bit more blue. That doesn't really translate well. I've never used this edge detail brush. Maybe it'll be okay for making like, I just want little trees like dotted all around. Are really hard to see. Let's make it a bit darker. Problem is, there's a lot of paint. I think I'm going to take some paint off. And this can be the water down here. Still not enough. I think I'm just going to use the fan brush. Still want this to be like blended.
Every now and then you can make one of these trees slightly bigger to give a little bit more to the painting. And that pushes all this stuff back here. Two hairs and some air. These paintings match the wallpaper of a grandma's. Have you studied the English language? The fuck was that sentence? Boy? Trying to give them a little bit of flavor. Give some tree trunks. The illusion of tree trunks. It's an illusion. My room is a historic building. Dumbass. I definitely want something here, like in this corner. I don't know about here though. Didn't like how white that spot was.
use some black, some of that blue that we were using with the purple. Just kind of slather this up. Wiggle it. Really fill up the brush with paint. The wiggle gives us this fucking zoom, straight ass fucking whatever. They'll cut you. Do I want that kind of tree? I'm having an identity crisis. At least this tree is. I can't use this brush. It's bad. It's like not a correct 1-inch brush. You can have one living on the water. It's kind of like right here. Every friend needs a tree. I mean, every tree needs a friend. Every friend needs a tree. Still don't like the lack of blue here. There we go. It's a little better. Thanks, Sword. Dude. Guess I can use this for a sort of a base coat of plants. Ah, fuck it. kind of want to cover up this shit, but I don't know how. Just with another fucking tree. Where's my thingy?
Grabbing some liquid white
so I can use it a bunch. I'm going to cut out a shoreline. I'm painting myself. Whoops. I don't like how fucking bad that is. It's the canvas, too. I don't know what to do about that. Well, whatever. It's part of the show. Now let's put in some other colored stuff all around. I'm gonna use some white, some red. It's going to be a really stark contrast. Oh man, didn't pick up enough. Can't exactly make green. So it's a bit tricky.
Use a little bit of paint thinner.
To get this to stick a bit better. Getting a lot of paint down here. I think the next painting won't have such a limited palette. It was a fun challenge, but I'm definitely missing some colors. Give a little bit of highlight. A little bit of mush on that side. That's okay. I'll get some more liquid white. I'm gonna give some tree trunks to the trees and call it a day. Let's just use a little bit of white and a little bit of red. Let the canvas take what it wants. I have an issue with always letting or making the tree trunks too wide. go back over
the fan brush. And I cover it in a couple spots. It's not supposed to be so obvious, you know. Scratching a couple branches here and there. Here we go. I'm not pleased with much of this painting, but I am pleased with this tree. This singular tree. Destroyed. I think there's just too much of a contrast between these two. They're supposed to be, you know, one farther away. I should have made these smaller. I also should have used way more colors. That's okay. Next time I'm going to use a full range of colors. And still have mountains, but not quite a mountainous scene. I think I'm gonna do more, sort of like this one where there's things in the foreground, like maybe even a cabin, maybe 10. Not sure. Oh my god, we finished with time to spare. Holy shit. Quicker than following Bob. That's going to do it for me tonight, guys. I got to clean up. I'll be on tomorrow, 10 p.m. Thanks, Sword. 10 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Someday I'm going to do another painting like that one, where it's just the whole thing's fucking mountains. Just all mountains. Tomorrow I'll be playing Dead by Daylight, most likely. Yeah. Come by, have some fun. I believe in you, Sword. We can paint together. It'll be good. But yeah, I'm gonna snake out of here somehow.
Crawl underneath my tripod. Alright.